Welcome to HUD's Housing Choice Voucher Overviews. This video will discuss the HCV Analysis Tool and the DrillDown Report. Today we hope you learn a bit more about these tools and how they can help PHAs make improvements in their HCV program. The HCV Analysis Tool, or HAT, and the DrillDown Report are two of the three tools provided for in the Tool of Tools. The third tool is the Payment Standard Tool and is discussed separately. Each of these tools provides different and important information to assist PHAs in understanding their HCV programs. The information in the two-year tool, and more broadly, help run an optimized HCV program. The HCV Analysis Tool uses a variety of data sources to create a report of the PHA voucher program ripe with analytical data. The tool compares the PHA's performance to other PHAs in the state and country. It also displays a variety of demographic information. The DrillDown Report is used to examine PIC data. It is an Excel document that examines family-specific information. In order to utilize these tools, you must first run an ad-hoc report. The first step is to log into WAS and access the PIC system. Once in the PIC system, the next step is to select the ad-hoc report. It is under the ad-hoc subheading. The correct report is called Form 50058 Ad-Hoc Report. The third step is to select All Voucher-Funded Assistance. On the next screen, you will select the first five actions as well as the seventh action. The actions are New Admission, Annual Reexamination, Interim Reexamination, Portability Move-In, Portability Move-Out, and Other Change of Unit. It is recommended to set the to line of the effective date of action to 1 to 2 months in advance of the current date in order to capture any re-exams the PHA may be processing in advance. Once the correct actions have been selected, you will select all fields for each section. This step contains two pages. Be sure to select all fields on both pages. Now that all the report specifications have been selected, you will export the report as an Excel file. For PHAs that have more than 10,000 records, you will need to download multiple files. The automatic setting for file type is set as a CSV file. Be sure to change the file type to XLS or XLSX, or use the Save As function to resave in Excel format prior to uploading in the Tool of Tools program. Prior to loading, you can open the file to verify all field loaded by scrolling to column KY. This should be the last column with data. Finally, save the file to a convenient place on your desktop to upload it into the tool. Once the ad-hoc report has been downloaded and saved, you will open up the Tool of Tools Excel document. You will be prompted to choose which report or reports you would like to run. As a reminder, there are three report options: the HCV Analysis Tool, the DrillDown Report, and the Payment Standard Tool. We will start with the HCV Analysis Tool. The HCV Analysis Tool, or HAT, is a PDF document that includes all kinds of exciting PHA analytics, like hold on to your hat exciting. Additionally, if a program is 15% or more project-based vouchers, or PBVs, then a second PDF is created which looks at PBV-specific metrics. After the introductory first page, Page 2 provides a demographic breakdown of program participants. This includes the head of household's race, ethnicity, age, disability status, homeless admission status, monthly income, new admissions income, and rent burden. The new admissions income can be a useful data source to ensure that 75% of new admissions are extremely low income. The third page is mostly related to payment standards, subsidy standards, and rent burden. The top table allows the PHA to see current rent burden and payment standards by voucher size. This may help in identifying needed changes to the payment standard. The lower table helps a PHA access subsidy standards via families choosing to overhouse themselves. Under the overhoused and underhoused section, the darker shaded orange indicates overhousing, when a unit size is larger than the voucher. The lighter shade oranges indicates a matching voucher to unit size. In this example, 53% families with a two-bedroom voucher are in a two-bedroom unit, whereas nearly 47% of families with a two-bedroom voucher are in a three-bedroom unit or larger. This outcome could be driven by many factors, but may indicate a need to adjust subsidy standards. Under the over-vouchered, under-vouchered section of the page, the table displays the number of people on a voucher and the family voucher size. In this case, 751 households of one person have a one-bedroom voucher size. Two households of one person each have a three-bedroom voucher, a potential indication of an inappropriate voucher size that a PHA should examine. The next three pages are the per-unit cost drivers and may help a PHA see fuller picture of its program as well as state and nationwide comparisons of key indicators. These comparative insights may help PHA re-examine parts of its program that may need further analysis, such as utility allowances. If utility trend lines are out of range from the state, it may indicate further examination. For example, if a PHA has a significantly lower utility allowance when compared to the state, which might be due to a PHA's failure to update allowances during previous few years, the PHA should look to update its allowances to be more in line with the current trends. The fifth page can help assess what may be driving overhousing and thus potentially subsidy standard concerns. Again, significant departures from the other state PHAs may indicate such concerns. For example, how many family members on each voucher compared to the state and country may demonstrate that the PHA has significantly more families that are overhousing themselves. In this case, the PHA trend lies within state and country. If the PHA trend line were well above state levels, it might be due to putting too many families on smaller bedroom voucher sizes, which may lead to overhousing. The final page includes a detailed program per unit cost on longer time frame, as well as children potentially in units with lead-based paint concerns, unit months leased, or UMLs, housing assistant payments, HAP, and budget authority, items that are also available in the two-year tool. These graphs give a much longer time frame, which can help PHAs identify various trends to understand changes in the program or local market and how to adjust its program as needed. The second report from the Tool of Tools we will discuss in this presentation is the DrillDown Report. The DrillDown Report takes raw data from PIC and allows the user to examine any oddities in the PIC data. It is an Excel document that examines family-specific information. The DrillDown Report offers a layer of auto-generated analysis that can help a PHA pinpoint potential issues in the program or even data entry errors in PIC. For example, using the over-vouchered filter, a PHA can compare column P, total number in household, with column Q, number of bedrooms on voucher, to identify potential concerns, such as one-person household with a three-bedroom voucher, as we saw earlier in the HAT. As another example, A similar analysis can be done in the Overhoused Filter tab. As a reminder, being overhoused is when unit size a household resides in is larger than the family's voucher size. This collective information is displayed in the PDF HAT report, but this drill-down tool allows the user to see individual families that are overhoused or underhoused. Further, a PHA may notice locally driven trends, such as the bulk of all overhousing is occurring in a particular zip code or section of town. As you can see, there are other filters the PHA can choose to apply in the drill-down report to assist in family-specific program analysis. It is important that PHAs use data to drive decision-making. The HAT and drill-down both present data in a way that can inform well-guided PHA decision-making. They each present different information in an easily accessible way to guide organizations in their pursuit of providing safe and secure housing to those in need. HUD representatives can also assist with the interpretation and functionality of these tools. This concludes the presentation on HUD's Tool of Tools, HAT, and Drilldown Report. Please check out the full series of webinars to learn more about the basics of Housing Choice Voucher Program. You can find those webinars at the following web address.